JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for June the 9th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded higher or unchanged against all but one of its major counterparts on Tuesday and during the Asian session Wednesday. It gained the most versus NZD, CAD and AUD in that order, while it underperformed only against the Swiss franc. The greenback was found virtually unchanged against the euro and the British pound. The relative strength of both the safe havens US dollar and Swiss franc, combined with the weakening in the commodity-linked Aussie, Kiwi and Loonie, suggests that market sentiment remained weak yesterday and today in Asia. Indeed, turning our gaze to the equity world, we see that most major EU indices closed in the red, with the only exceptions being France's CAC 40 and the UK FTSE 100, which gained 0.11 and 0.25% respectively. Later in the US, the Dow slid, the S&P 500 was unchanged, and the Nasdaq added 0.31%. As for today in Asia, appetite remained soft, with only China Shanghai Composite trading in positive waters. With no clear catalyst once again, it seems that investors prefer to stay cautious ahead of tomorrow's inflation data from the US. As we already noted on Monday and yesterday, expectations are for both the headline core rates to rise again, further above the Fed's objective of 2%, which could add to the perception that the surging inflationary pressures may not be due to transitory factors. Something like that could increase speculation that the Fed may have to start scaling back its monetary policy support sooner than previously thought, and perhaps result in further retreat in equities and other risk-linked assets. At the same time, the US dollar and other safe havens may come under buying interest. Now, today, the main event on the agenda may be the Bank of Canada interest rate decision. At its latest meeting, this bank kept its benchmark interest rate unchanged at 0.25%, but decided to scale back its quantitative easing purchases. Since then, both the headline and core CPI rates for the month of April surged, and although the GDP slowed in the first quarter of the year, the expansion accelerated notably in March. However, on Friday, the employment report for May showed that the unemployment rate ticked up to 8.2% from 8.1%, and that the economy has lost 68,000 more jobs after losing 207,100 in April. Thus, although the spike in the CPIs and the decent GDP data may dismiss questions as to whether the bank has acted correctly in scaling back its bond purchases at the last gathering, the soft employment report is unlikely to lead to more tapering at this meeting. That said, an upbeat tone in the statement hinting that further tapering may be in the works in the works for the months to come may be enough to support the loonie in the short run. Now, as for the rest of today's events, apart from the Bank of Canada monetary policy decision, the only other item on the financial agenda worth mentioning is the Energy Information Administration report on crude oil inventories for last week. The forecast points to a 2.036 million barrels slide following a 5.080 million barrels fall the week before, something which is supported by the American Petroleum Institute report, which revealed a 2.108 million barrels decline during the same week. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.